श्री हरि शरणम् सच्चिदानंद रूपाय विश्वत्पत्यादि हेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्री कृष्णाय वयं नमः। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेत कृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरा जुहावं पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तरवोभिनेदुः तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि। यस्वानुभावमखिलश्रुतिसारमेकं अध्यात्मदीपमतितीर्षतान्तमोन्धं संसारिणां करुणयाः पुराणगुह्यं तं व्याससूनुमुपयामि गुरुमुनीनाम्। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। निगमकल्पतरुर्गलितं फलं सुखमुखादमृतं द्रवसंजुतं पिबत भागवतं रसमालयं गुरु रसिका भुवि भावुका। नमः परमहंसास्वादितचरणकमलचिन्मकरन्दाय भक्तजनमानसनिवासाय श्रीरामचन्द्राय श्रीकृष्णचन्द्राय बागीशायस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि जस्यास्ते हृदये संवित् तं नृसिंहमहं भजे। विश्वसर्ग विसर्गादि नवलक्षण लक्षितं श्रीकृष्णाख्यं परं धाम जगद्धाम नमाम तत्। अथ एकादश स्कंद एकोनत्रिंशोऽध्याय चतुस्त्रिंश श्लोका। मर्त्यो जदा त्यक्त समस्त कर्मा निवेदितात्मा विचिकीर्षितो मे तदा मृतत्वं प्रतिपद्यमानो मयात्म भूयाय च कल्पते वै। भगवान श्री कृष्ण एकादश स्कंद में प्यारे उद्धव को बता रहे हैं, हे उद्धव, मनुष्य को ज्ञान कर्म योग वाणिज्य और राजदंड आदि से क्रमशः मोक्ष धर्म काम और अर्थ रूप फल प्राप्त होते हैं, परंतु तुम्हारे जैसे अनन्य भक्तों के लिए वो चारों प्रकार के फल केवल मैं ही हूँ। जिस समय मनुष्य समस्त कर्मों को परित्याग करके मुझे आत्म समर्पण कर देता है, उस समय वो मेरा विशेष माननीय हो जाता है और मैं उसे उसके जीवत्व से छुड़ाकर अमृतत्व स्वरूप मोक्ष की प्राप्ति करा देता हूँ और वह मुझसे मिलकर मेरा स्वरूप हो जाता है। अब हम श्रीधर स्वामी का टीका देखेंगे। कुत इत्यत आह मर्त्यंगिति जदा त्यक्त समस्त कर्मा सन में निवेदितात्मा भवति तदा असौ में विचिकीर्षितो विशिष्टः कर्तुनिष्ठो भवति ततश्चामृतत्वं मोक्षं प्रतिपद्यमानः मयात्मभूयाय मत् ऐक्याय मत् समान ऐश्वर्याय इति जावत् कल्पते योग्य भवति। सिद्धरकृता भावार्थ दीपिका प्रकाश टीका। यदवा जदा कृपया मे विचिकीर्षितस्तथा त्यक्त समस्त कर्मा विविच्य बाधित सर्व कार्योपाधि रूपावरण बाधेन तत्कृत भेद भ्रमापनयनेन मयेव निवेदितात्म स्वरूपो नन्यो मृतत्वं प्रतिपद्यमानो मया सहत्म भूयाय कल्पदैति जावद्यावन्निरस्यायं देहादिन प्रत्यगञ्चति तावत्तावत् तदर्थोऽपि त्वर्थं प्रविविक्षति। इति स्फुत्युक्त न्यायेन जदायं जीवो ब्रह्माभिमुखो भवति तदा ब्रह्मोऽपि जीवन्मुखो भवति इति अर्थः। जमेवैष वृणुते तेन लभ्य इति श्रुते ननु मया सर्व मतान्यवदतानि किन्तु त्वद्भक्तानां किं मतं तत्त्वं ब्रूहि इति अपेक्षायां आह भो उद्धव। प्रणयिन चतुर्विंशाध्याये सत्कार्यवादीनां अष्टाविंशाध्याये तथैवाद् असत्कार्यवादीनां च मतम् उक्तं मद्भक्ता तो व्यादिता, मद्भक्ता तो विवादिनः, सत्यवादिनः संतो वस्तुतस्तु तदुभय मतमध्यतो नैव भवन्ति इति आह मर्त्य इति। मनुष्यो जदा जादृच्छिक मद्भक्त कृपा प्रसादात् त्यक्तानि समस्तानि नित्य नैमित्तिक काम्यानि कर्माणि येन सह निवेदितात्वा मत स्वरूप भूताय मन मंत्रोपदेशकाय गुरवे जोहम ममास्ति यत्किंचित् दिह लोके परत्र च तत्सर्वं भवतो नाथ चरणेषु समर्पितम् इति वचसा मनसा च समर्पिताहम् तास्पद ममतास्पद भवति तदा तत्क्षणमारभ्यैव स मर्त्यो मे मया चिकीर्षितः विशिष्टः कर्तुमिष्टः। मत् प्रतिपद्यमानेन मत् भक्त्याभासेन योगी ज्ञानी प्रसूतितोपि विलक्षण एव कर्तुम् इच्छतः तेन मया कार्य सत्यभूत एव नाप्य विद्या कार्य मिथ्याभूत एव मत् कार्य गुणातीत एव सन् अमृतत्वं मृतं नाशस्तद् भाववत्त्वं प्रतिपद्यमानः मया सहैवात्म भूयाय स्वभूत्ये कल्पते योग्यो भवति चकारेण फलम् अननुसंगितं फलम् तु प्रेमवत् पार्षदत्वम् इति। लॉर्ड कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड हाउ ए मोर्टल बीइंग कैन अटेन हिम। मर्त्यो जदा त्यक्त समस्त कर्मा निवेदितात्मा विचिकीर्षितो मिं तदामृतत्वं प्रतिपद्यमानो मयात्म भूयाय च कल्पते वै। व्हेन ए मोर्टल बीइंग हैज रिनाउंस्ड ऑल मटेरियल एक्टिविटीज एंड इज टोटली सरेंडर्ड टू मी देन बाय माय डिजायर ही इज ग्रांटेड इमोर्टैलिटी एंड बिकम्स सिचुएटेड इन दिस सेल्फ। द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्स इज taking initiation from a qualified guru, a mortal being gives up all material activities. That means he renounces all desires that can be fulfilled through varnashrama dharma and surrenders the atma, that is the sense of I, me, mine, etc. to me here represented by the guru. An example of surrendering the Atma is, O Lord, whatever I am, whatever I possess here in this world and after death, I offer at your feet. When a person surrenders in this way, then although his mind, body and senses are illusory, I desire to make him special. Thus, as I have said, one who takes shelter of me becomes nirguna. This is how my devotees becomes free from the gunas of material nature. He is not perishable as a product of maya, nor is he illusory as an outcome of ignorance. Being a product of my own special attention, he becomes situated in his swarupa, that is his own nature. Moreover, instead of saying that he is made special, the implication of this word, when the Lord begins to make him nirguna, then slowly by the practice of bhakti, the devotee attains the stages of nishtha, ruchi, asakti and rati, and thus becomes completely nirguna. After that, he has no dealings with any illusory objects. But before he attains this stage, he continues to deal with the material objects as needed by him in the service of the Lord. The verse here therefore indicates, already at the time of initiation, by my translogical power, I invisibly create the transcendental body of the devotee, his mind and senses of such a nature to demonstrate the greatness of devotion. So here it is proven that material nature of a devotee dissolves through devotion. In Srimad Bhagavatam 5th canto 1st chapter and 35 shloka, Sri Sukadev Goswami explains that the mind, body, senses of a devotee are not only freed from material bondage but literally destroyed, yet the body remains visible. He refers to the wonderful act of King Priyabrata, who once followed the sun in his chariot so that there would always be light, and thus created seven oceans. Indeed, such an achievement is not wonderful for those who have controlled the six enemies of the power of the dust of the feet of Lord Krishna, who performs wonderful deeds. But what is wonderful indeed that a person born as an outcast, for example, not qualified for any Vedic rituals, becomes free from the material body immediately just by chanting the name of Lord Sri Krishna once. The meaning of this verse is as follows. Even a deed like creating seven oceans, as King Priyabrata had done, doesn't seem wonderful in comparison to the effect of bhakti that even a vidura vigata, that means the lowest born person, by chanting the name of Lord Urukrama Sri Krishna even once, immediately at that very moment becomes free from the material body. Although his body remains visible, it is no longer material. The material body, which was product of prarabdha karma, has fallen away. This, taken together with the previously cited 11th canto 29th chapter and 34th shloka, indicates at that very moment, becoming freed from the mortality, acquiring a spiritual body, the devotee becomes situated with me. This means that wherever Krishna is situated, the devotee is also situated there for the sole purpose of serving him. In this way, whatever material objects he comes into contact with in this world, their material nature is dissolved by the Supreme Lord because of their contact with devotion. At that very moment, he creates supremely real objects according to the desire of his devotee. What is impossible for the Lord, who has translogical powers? Therefore, the statements of Krishna cited earlier, such as my devotion is Nirguna and my temple is Nirguna, are very appropriate. In this context, we can also refer to the following verse of Sanatan Das Goswami from Brihad Bhagavatamritam. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deha Daihika Vismrten Teshan Bhautika Dehepi Satchit Ananda Rupata. After drinking the nectar of devotion to Krishna, devotees forget about their material bodies and all things related to them. Even in their material bodies, the transcendental qualities of eternity, knowledge and bliss becomes manifest. Similarly, in Chaitanya Charitamritam Antya Lila 4.191-93, Lord Sri Chaitanya says, Prabhu kahe Vaishnava deha prakrita kahu noy aprakrita deha bhakter chit anandama. The Lord said, the body of a Vaishnava is never material. His body is transcendental, made up of chit and ananda. Whenever a person surrenders himself at the time of diksha or initiation, at that very moment, Krishna makes him just like himself. Jai Sri Krishna.